Family meetings are core to palliative care, and I think from my perspective they should be offered routinely to all patients and families. They're an opportunity for the patient, ideally, if they're capable of coming to the family meeting, and primary family caregivers and the key healthcare professionals that need to be there to have time to talk about the status of the patient and also the implications of their illness and clarification around what are the goals of care for the patient, what are the goals of care for the family members, what are the goals of care for the healthcare professionals, so there can be a united approach to the care that's provided. And that is the ideal, that healthcare professionals in partnership with the patient and family caregivers can come up with a unified approach so that the patient's well-being is supported and they get the best possible care and also the family members get the best possible care. And I think the strategies for conducting those family meetings are important. I think one of the things that need to be recognised is trying to get some clarification on what are the issues for the patient and or the family prior to the family meeting. So there is some sense of, you know, what do we actually want to, you know, discuss in this family meeting, recognising too that through discussion other issues will come up for the patient and family member and indeed the healthcare professionals. I think it's helpful if the person conducting the family meeting is someone who's skilled in that regard, who feels comfortable in facilitating a meeting where, you know, often difficult discussions are taking place, where there might need to be some clarification, dealing with some often very difficult issues around death and dying, so you need somebody who can actually facilitate that discussion. I think it's important to acknowledge that the family meeting's not the point where people should actually be disclosing, you know, the diagnosis and so forth. I think those sort of case medical discussions should happen separately. The focus, I think, of a family meeting should be around what are the important needs that need to be met, how do we plan care, what are the goals of care, and they would be the sort of the key elements. And giving everybody, again, permission and opportunity to talk, to make it clear that they're going to be here, you know, potentially for, you know, maybe half an hour or an hour, and making sure that the patient and family member are aware of why the meeting's being conducted. And I think too, making sure that there's not too many healthcare professionals in the room. I think it's only those healthcare professionals that need to be there. I think it's pretty confronting, particularly, you know, for an elderly person, an elderly caregiver to come in from the suburbs, for example, to come into a, you know, big hospital, to walk into a room with, you know, seven or eight healthcare professionals and to be asked to, you know, to talk about their concerns around death and dying. I think that's potentially a little bit too much for many family caregivers. So only the healthcare professionals that need to be there. And I think an important role of the facilitator of those meetings is to wrap up at the end, to kind of just confirm the decisions that have been made so that there's clarity with regards to next steps, the goals of care are clear, and that there is a plan that's put in place and enacted upon thereafter. So that's the kind of ideal, I think, in terms of setting up and conducting a family meeting. But I think acknowledging that they take time and they take skills in terms of chairing and facilitating those meetings, and to make sure that, again, that the focus is on the patient and family and the priority issues for the patient and family, because often an hour or so is not a lot of time once you start talking. So you really want to get at the core issues wherever you can.